Hello guys, GeeseGeek here, and today I'm up with another crazy redstone tutorial. Today we're gonna be making 3x3 water door, a very unique and compact, as you can see, not the most compact design, but relatively unique, so without wasting any time, let's move into the tutorial. Okay, so for this, you're gonna be starting by adding a simple layout for the 3x3 unique door. So just do like I'm doing. Now for the size, just add sticky pistons like the normal ones. After the adding side pistons, you're gonna be having something like this. Now for the top and bottom pistons, it's gonna be a little bit different. We're gonna need a have a one block gap between them. So another mention that you're gonna be need these corner blocks for the bottom of the door. Take out your solid blocks and make a V shape just like this. Add a piece of redstone dust there. And remember, it needs to be a dot like this. So here goes your lever. Add a sticky piston with a block of redstone there. Add slab there. Solid block. Redstone dust. Torch. Get redstone dust from below the torch, go into a two tick repeater, into block with the redstone dust. Now duplicate the following on the other side and you're pretty much done. So now that you've added the both the size, the wiring, now we need to connect the bottom pistons. So you need to pick out the side, right side, no rest is a mutt. That's a personal choice. So let's take an output from this block of redstone going into a regular tick repeater, just the V shape, regular V shape, just like this. Another piece of redstone dust there. So now that you've wired up the bottom pistons, also it's time to add a little bit body to the door, just like this. I've also I've done the other side. So now it's actually time to add the water sources in here. So we're going to be adding water sources in this place, right here. So make sure to cut off any spaces, just like this, and put your water sources in here. Now let's give it a try. Yep, it works perfectly fine. Like this. But we're gonna notice something. Maybe if I do this, it's gonna do the awkward thing. Or maybe if I do this and let's do a little bit something like this, it's gonna do very strange behavior, just like this. And why is that? You're gonna need to match these, like. Now it's above, I'm removing this. Now it's flush with the wall and it's floor, and it's not flush with the floor. You need to match these. If it's up, it needs to be up too. If it's down, it needs to be down too. So just like this. Oh, there are no water sources. So if it's just like this, you need to give it a push, like this, and it's worked perfectly. So now, as you can see, the door itself is looking properly, but you don't want to fly over it and then push this lever or view this ugly, hideous restaurant. You want some fancy little inputs. So for this, I'm gonna making a simple panel. I'm not good with building, you know, you're better than me at these. So I'm gonna be adding a simple some more body to the panel. So some blocks, one or two should do the trick. For the sake of this tutorial, can go mad with these doors. So I'm gonna be doing a well, let's actually make another one, come out one more block. So I'm gonna be adding a T flip-flop. The button would be input, and as you know, two flip-flops are used to convert a falls into a continuous power. So it takes into continuous pulse. So if you're not familiar with T flip flops, you can check out my other video on T flip flops. So let me take up some wool here, and here's a simple. Oops, I'm destroying. I'm destructive these days. So let's go in here. And we need to connect these. So we have some ugly problems. Just add a block here to prevent these from connecting. And yep, add a torch here. Get some other wool. And a piston going here. A piston, excuse me, repeater going in there. Rain again, rain. Now, two redstone like this to another, a torch right there, two repeaters on 40. Now, here's your output. I'm gonna be digging up straight. Now, not digging, but going up straight. Just like this. And do a little bit like. You can see we have added a T-flip-flop circuit. We've connected these both with the OR gates to a T-flip-flop circuit, and then transferred the power up to here. It's that simple as this. Now you can see it's working great. We can enable or disable this door from here. We can also do the same from here. If I remember to add the button like this, great. Thank you guys, this is it for this episode. So if you guys like this episode, make sure to like, leave a like down below, and if you really loved it, then make sure to subscribe. This has been GeeseGeek, and I'm out.